vlog, mommy.
Yeah, yeah. Let's just do it. Let's do it. Let's vlog. Let's vlog. Let's do it. Yeah.
Nixon's watching.
So it'll be pretty late when we get to the hotel, so we will catch up with you guys tomorrow. Sound good?
Yeah. Yeah. We're gonna see you later, hot dogs.
Welcome back to the vlog. So yesterday we had a pretty good day at the track, and you probably saw some footage and a montage just before this. And where do we even begin? Last night we went to bed late. We were having fun. Nixon, what were you doing outside playing with other kids? You had some poppers?
Yeah, and like the firework looking thingy.
The sparkler? Oh, you had a sparkler last night?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I had two of them.
Wow. Cool. Well, Nixon was doing that. We went to bed a little late. Sam and I probably ended up going to bed at like 12:30. Mm-hmm. At 1:30 a.m., we woke up to the sound of an alarm in our RV, and it was for the propane and carbon monoxide. Mm-hmm. So obviously I freaked out. I mean, I just wanted to take it seriously because we don't know. It's not our RV. We don't really know.
Yeah.
So we got the kids out to the car to be safe. Mm-hmm. And then Sam spent an hour on the phone with their customer service.
Yeah.
Which was worthless. And I was Googling a bunch of stuff about what it could be. And then at first it was just beeping, like, this is way too much information
one beep
for the
every
vlog.
3 seconds.
But
yeah.
And then it started getting like it's closer together and like more urgent and turned completely red. So at that point I was like, okay, we need to call the fire department because I didn't want to bring the kids back in there not knowing, like, and so I just wanted them to come check. So this poor soul from the volunteer fire department in the middle of nowhere, Ohio, came out and checked it and said there was nothing in there.
No reading of any.
No reading. And at this point, the alarm had also stopped. And this is now like 3 a.m. or 3:30 a.m.
Yep, yep.
Finally got the kids back to bed by 4 a.m.
Yep.
We were back in bed a little after that. And then at 5:30, it went off again.
Yep.
So we've been up since. We just got, I got coffee with an espresso shot. Sam has a double, triple.
Triple.
And I have orange.
And poor Nixon has orange juice. So now we have no idea what we're doing.
All the hotels are booked.
All the hotels are booked.
Unless we want to drive an hour.
Yeah.
So we're counting on some customer service from...
Oh, we probably shouldn't say. I don't want to, like, call these people out.
Yeah.
We'll edit that out. But maybe I will want to call them out after this.
We might.
So, yeah.
That's where we are. We're sitting here in some parking lot of a hotel next to the Dunkin' Donuts.
Wait, then we can be in the hotel.
I think at this point, we might as well just go back to the track. I was hoping that we could get some sleep somewhere, but that doesn't seem like it's gonna happen, so. What do you want?
I want you to put a banana right up there.
When Nixon woke up at, like, when we got him up the first time at, like, 2:30 in the morning, he was sitting in the car, and we were waiting for the fire department to get there. He was, like, talking about, he was seeing cartoon vegetables in the sky, and he was, like, slap happy delirious.
I'm gonna have a muffin.
I wanna have them. I wanna have the one that has the seed.
What, it got a little too late for something last night. What did we tell you it was too late for?
I guess we should go and do it right now.
SMP.
Yeah, some s'mores. We told Nixon, okay, we'll do s'mores after dinner. It got too late. We said, well, you know what? Let's do s'mores for breakfast.
Might as well.
We can start right now, I guess. We can set up the we set up
do
the grill.
Else.
Oh, man.
I guess I can. I want to have a s'more. And
to
that people point.
Yeah, right. We'll try and go back, bud.
Let's just go back. There's nothing else we can do out here.
A cliff.
Yeah, nothing else.
Might as well just sit in our car at the campsite.
Yep. Might be it.
All right. See you in the campsite.
Bye, everybody.
Yeah.
We are back in the RV. Update. The guys came out. They checked the propane tanks, checked our battery. Turns out our battery was shot, and that was causing the alarm to go off and just a bunch of other, just a mess. So they replaced our battery for us, refilled our generators, since we had to use extra generator juice to power it because our battery was low or shot or whatever. So we're good. Last night went perfectly fine. We slept through the whole night. No alarms, so it was awesome. Now is race day. So we are gonna go out to the S's to watch the Indy cars with Grandma and Granddad, and we'll take you along. And you probably saw, last night we got to see fireworks out here. So probably saw some clips of that. So we'll catch up with you soon.
Ready to say bye to the RV?
Bye, RV.
Bye, RV. We'll miss you. Come here.
All right, everybody, did we have a good time?
Yeah.
We did.
Even after the rough first night?
Yes.
Yes, everything was made up for.
All right. Are they waiting for you?
No. Okay. I already talked to them. These are my friends.
Sam made friends here. So did Nixon.
Yeah, Nixon did too.
Will you do it again next year?
I think so. I think we're much better prepared.
Now that we've done it once, I feel like I could do it again and, yeah. And know more of what to do.
Yep, we could do it.
Would you do it again?
What?
Would you do it again?
Yes, but I would go in that big one that's leaving.
Oh, you want a really big
Whoa.
One?
Oh. Yeah, he wants an RV.
A huge one. All right. We will probably catch up with you on the next
one. Wait, I want that one.
That one? That's close to what we have. All right.
So many choices.
See you guys later.
Bye.
Take a shot and I aim high.